This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Great Heck Rail Crash, widely known as the Selby Rail Crash, was a high-speed train accident that occurred at Great Heck near Selby, North Yorkshire, England on the morning of 28 February 2001. 10 people died, including the drivers of both trains involved, and 82 people suffered serious injuries. It remains the worst rail disaster in the 21st century in the United Kingdom. Contents 1 Events 2 Outcome 3 Aftermath 4 Legal Proceedings 5 See also 6 References 7 External Links Events. The crash occurred at approximately 6:13 Greenwich Mean Time, when a Land Rover Defender towing a loaded trailer carrying a Renault Savanna estate car swerved off the westbound M62 motorway just before a bridge over the East Coast Main Line. The vehicle ran down an embankment and onto the southbound railway track. The Land Rover's driver, Gary Neil Hart, tried to reverse it off the track, but he could not while he was using a mobile telephone to call the emergency services. After exiting the vehicle, the Land Rover was hit by a southbound GNER InterCity 225 heading from Newcastle to London King's Cross. The InterCity 225 was propelled by a Class 91 locomotive number 91023 and led by a driving van trailer DVT. After striking the Land Rover, the leading bogie of the DVT derailed, but the train stayed upright. Points to nearby sidings then deflected it into the path of an oncoming Freightliner freight train carrying coal and traveling from Immingham to Ferrybridge, hauled by a Class 66 locomotive number 66521. The freight train hit the wreckage approximately half a mile 642. Immediately before the impact of the two trains, the speed of the InterCity 225 was estimated as 88. Steve Baldwin, from York. Christopher Terry, from York. Robert Shakespeare, from Beverly. The coaches of the InterCity 225 were carrying 99 passengers and train staff. The early morning 4:45 time departure from Newcastle resulted in reduced passenger numbers, as it was 45 of the 52 seriously injured passengers, and all 8 fatalities excluding the 2 locomotive drivers were traveling in the first 5 coaches, which included a restaurant car and 2 first-class coaches with less densely packed seating than standard coaches. In total, 82 survivors were taken to hospital. The official incident report praised the crashworthiness of the InterCity 225's Mark IV coaches. An unusual aspect of the emergency response was the need to carry out disinfecting procedures at the scene owing to the 2001 UK foot and mouth crisis in the United Kingdom at the time of the incident. Aftermath: a memorial to the Great Heck Rail Disaster. Hart escaped the incident unscathed and was later tried on 10 counts of causing death by dangerous driving. Locomotive number 66526 has since been named driver Steve Dunn George, in memory of the Freightliner driver killed in the accident. It carries a plaque commemorating the accident in remembrance of a dedicated engineman. Driver Steve George Dunn was tragically killed in the accident at Great Heck on 28 February 2001. Dunn's son James, who was 9 at the time of the crash, later became a train driver. John Weddle, the GNER driver killed in the accident, was also honored by way of a new driver training school in his home city of Newcastle, which was named after him in a ceremony attended by members of his family. His 16-year-old daughter Stephanie unveiled a plaque dedicating the school to his memory. Barry Needham, also a railway employee, was also commemorated by the naming of 60,087 after him, the plates later being transferred to 60,091. This locomotive also carries an explanatory plaque. Coincidentally, 91,023 was also involved in the Hatfield rail crash 4 months earlier. The locomotive escaped with only slight damage on both occasions following technical upgrade of the Class 91 fleet, which led to all locomotives having 100 added to the number. 91,001 became 91,101, etc. 91,023 was renumbered 91,132, not 91,123. Legal proceedings. Hart denied the charges, claiming that his car had suffered a mechanical fault, or had collided with an object on the road. An investigation, including reconstruction of the Land Rover to demonstrate that it was not mechanically defective, concluded that Hart had been driving in a sleep-deprived condition, and had not applied the brakes as it went down the embankment. It later transpired that Hart had stayed up the previous night talking on the telephone to a woman he had met through an internet dating agency. Hart later stated that although he had witnessed the impact between the InterCity 225 and his Land Rover, he had not been aware of the more serious collision with the freight train until informed by police several hours later on 13 December 2001. 2001 he was found guilty and given a 5-year sentence, of which he served 30 months in prison. Campaigners drew attention to what they claimed was the inadequate length of the crash barriers alongside the motorway. According to the Health and Safety Executive's final report, the Land Rover had left the road 30 yards before the barrier started and had easily broken through the simple wooden fence that lined the track. A 2003 Highways Agency review of crash barriers on bridges over railways concluded that only 3 bridges nationwide were in need of upgrading. The bridge at Great Heck was not one of them. By October 2003, Hart's insurers had paid out over £22 million. Gary Hart's insurers, through Hart's name, sued the Department for Transport for a contribution to damages paid to GNER and the victims, alleging a degree of causation on the grounds that the safety barrier was inadequate contributory negligence. The High Court judge ruled the loss was too remote from any perceived shortcoming with standard national infrastructure, noting the jury's verdict and previous findings of fact. See also list of rail accidents in the United Kingdom. Pullman rail crash, a similar accident where a train propelled from the rear by a locomotive struck an object on the railway. Hatfield rail crash, an earlier accident also involving an InterCity 225 powered by 91,023 Oxshott rail crash, a concrete mixer lorry fell from a bridge onto a train. 2005 Glendale train crash, a later event also involving a car on the track and collisions with other trains. References. Carrot rail crash unavoidable report. Mail online the 24th of February 2011. Retrieved the 24th of February 2011. March 2001 retrieved the 24th of February 2014. Carrot the Encyclopedia of Modern Traction Names. Carrot courage of families praised at Great Heck Memorial Service. The York Press the 28th of February 2011. Retrieved the 4th of March 2015. Highways Agency – Crash Report. One Life – Asleep at the Wheel at True North Productions. VE Railway Accidents in 2001.